as I am unable to speak in your mother tongue, which is one of the most beautiful languages, Tamil. மலையாளமும் தமிழுக்கு பக்கத்து தான் நிற்கிறது. தமிழ் மலையாளம் ஜாஸ்தி வித்தியாசம் இல்லை. Today the topic on which the seminar is being organized as part of the Tamil Nadu State Conference of Communist Party of India Marxists is left alternative in Tamil Nadu. And a good deal of this topic has already been covered by a very eminent and very senior leader of the left movement in the state of Tamil Nadu. I think our Barish would also be at least briefly speaking after my presentation. Now I would originally thought of dealing with this topic, covering different aspects, taking half an hour to 45 minutes. But now since time is late, and also because of the fact that most of the points have already been covered by eminent speakers earlier, I want to focus only a few points on this particular important topic. First of all, what do we mean by left? We all know that. Recently, by reading a very long interview with one of the most outstanding thinkers of the world, who passed away very recently, he is known as the most respected historian who lived till recently. His name is Erich Hobsbawm. Most of you might have heard about him and may have read his works. He died at the age of 93 or 94, and he was very active during his death. He is one of the tallest intellectuals of the times. And he retained, maintained, protected his membership in Communist Party of India. At the same time, many friends who are present here would know that he used to be critical about the positions of various Communist parties, including Communist Party of India. And his criticism always used to be with the intentions to help Communist parties to correct certain aberrations according to him, which one Communist Party or the other was under. This much about Erich Hobsbawm. Most of you know, but to set record straight, I summarize his position. In this particular long interview, there is one section which is titled as "What is left out of the left?" That is the title. Very interesting title. It can be that title itself can be interpreted in different ways. First interpretation could be, is there something not as left? Is anything left out? Another meaning of the title would be, what is the left of the left? There is a left note, but there has to be something left to the left. That is, left is not sufficiently left according to some. So therefore you should also explore whether there are different shapes within the left. Anyway, it is a philosophical dimension also. And in the present day discourse, again, there are sections who claims to be from the left. At the same time, they are critical of some sections of society, political, ideological, who are not as left. So it's a very complex problem. Here, like many other outstanding philosophers and ideologues, the concept of what is left is being explained by Eric Hobsbawm, which we all know. Left forces are those who want to restructure society, which is based on exploitation, where you find inequity among various sections of society. Society with oppression, exploitation. Various sections are being driven out to the margins of society. In short, leftists always look forward to a society free from oppression and exploitation. Leftists are unhappy with the status quo, the society in which they live. And they want a transformation in society. And what is their transformation? There can be differences. But leftists as a whole want society to be changed. Then there are some sections being defined as progressives. Then we also come across the term like left of the center. So there is that kind of a left. They are left, but they are very near to the center. But they are unhappy with center. Therefore they stand left of the center. Anyway, due to paucity of time, you don't have to take more time to define different shades of leftism. But there is a very interesting question which Eric Hobsbawm in his own characteristic way dealt with. That question is there a right? And according to the leftists, the political right is not right, they are wrong. Isn't it? So how do you define a right? A rightist, reactionary, conservative section in society. There the definition of Eric Hobsbawm is so beautiful. And I feel like hugging him and giving him a kiss. He, in a very scientific and simple manner, Eric Hobsbawm says, when we have a discourse, when we have a debate regarding the distinction in society between the right and the left, those who say that there is no right and left, they are the right, they are the reactionary, they are the conservatives, who refuse to recognize a distinction in society between the right and the left. We come across many who say that, oh, what is left, what is right, everything is the same. Those who argue like this, they are the rightists in society, who try to erase the distinctions. Still somebody would say, now the complexities that exist in the present day world, it is different from the times of Communist Manifesto, 1848. when according to Marx and Engels, the entire world is separated into two great different segments who engage in class struggle. The distinctions in society was very much simplified by capitalist society and the emergence of bourgeois. Now, to make a fast forward, the ingenious ways, very clever, criminally clever ways through which bourgeoisie behave, giving share of the company to some sections of workers and making workers believe that they are also owners of their company, isn't it? Thereby trying to remove the realization by workers that they are being exploited. When they have some shares, they feel this factory belongs to me also, isn't it? So there are many methods. But to disabuse the mind, few weeks ago, in fact, when we were having our party subcommittee committee meeting in Hyderabad to finalize our draft documents, political resolution as well as draft document on political tactical line, political tactical review of political tactical line. Report of the Oxfam appeared in many newspapers about how wealth of the world is getting concentrated